Well, I bet you never thought you'd see the day. To be fair, I didn't really think so either. But this is a Patreon request by Colette39, who wanted me to check out the song Fortnite by Taylor Swift featuring Post Malone. So for those who don't know, for those who are new around here, I'm a metalhead who branches out and explores all different kinds of music on this channel. But I never thought I'd be checking out this artist. This is going to be quite interesting. I don't really have any preconceived notions about this artist. Yes, I don't necessarily have a super high opinion of a lot of mainstream American music, especially pop music. However, I do know a few things about Taylor Swift just because she's so popular. I don't completely live under a rock. I do hear things. And from what I've heard, she does seem like a genuinely talented and hardworking artist. The number of hours that I've heard she puts in for each performance, like 3 to 4 hour performance, these big arenas day after day, that is clearly a very hardworking person. And I don't know how she has the energy to do that. So, you know, I just hear certain things that lead me to believe that she is more than just the cut and paste generic pop artist. And I don't even believe that's a good term because I think that she's so far above that. From what I understand, she dabbles in all different types of genres of music and is also apparently a skilled guitar player. So she's kind of her own genre. And I've heard that she's very creative, very intelligent, very talented. So I'm sure that will speak for itself in the music. Other than that, I've never actually sit down and listened to any of her music, obviously. I've heard like three main things about her. I know that there was a song that was trending a few years ago where people were remixing it with clips of Screaming Goats. That was a really weird trend. I know that she was all over the news lately due to being dating some football player who was really popular. Shows how much I know about sports. I don't even remember his name. And I also know that she did some song or music video where she apparently got accused of being satanic, which, of course, is absolutely ridiculous. That's really what I know about her so far. I'm sure I've heard some of her songs, but I couldn't put her name to them or anything. I couldn't remember them, you know, off the top of my head. But I'm sure I've heard something in a car radio or in a grocery store or something, given how popular she is, to where if you sat me down and you played one of those songs, I'd be like, oh yeah, that's vaguely familiar. I probably heard that at some point. So it's that kind of thing. So I don't know what I'm in for, but I do know this is her newest song. As for Post Malone, I have heard one or two songs by him. I like Post Malone. I think he's a chill guy. He's also really into metal, so he's one of us for sure. And yeah, without further ado, I think I'm just going to dive into this and see what it's all about. But before I jump in, I'm Blake X. This is Nuclear Reactions. If you're new around here, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Check out my Patreon for bonus content, linked in the description down below. If you join Tier 4 on my Patreon, you can make a song request and guarantee a reaction to it. So if you want to get in on that VIP treatment, definitely check it out. All right, Taylor Swift, Fortnite, featuring Post Malone, official music video. Fingers crossed this doesn't get blocked. I'm really hoping, guys. We'll see. Let's check this out.
I was supposed to be sent away, but they forgot to come and get me. I was a functioning alcoholic till nobody noticed my new aesthetic.
Okay, right off the bat, that beat sounds very retro, right? Vaguely 80s-ish. If anything, it reminds me of some synthwave that I've heard over the years. There was this one song, I think it was called A Real Human or A Real Hero, something like that. And it was done by this synthwave band called Electric Youth. And they basically did the song, I think, for the film Drive. And that was very synthwavey, but it had a beat that is very similar to this. So that's what that reminds me of. Interesting so far. I don't know what to make of the visuals at all. Yeah, we'll see where we're going with it. But let's take it back to the beginning and start that again.
Supposed to be sent away, but they forgot to come and get me. I was a functioning alcoholic till nobody noticed my new aesthetic. All of this to say, I hope you're okay, but you're the reason.
Okay, so I have some thoughts. I like the kind of, I don't know if surreal is the right term, but sort of surreal elements going on in the video. Like the upside down doctor, like the weird bed on the wall. I've also heard that she has a lot of symbolism in her videos and in her songs themselves. So let me know if she writes her songs, how much creative control she has over it. I'm assuming a lot, especially for a mainstream artist. But I do know that there, just from what I've heard, because I've heard so much word of mouth about this artist, that there's like a lot of like, you know, very carefully crafted symbolism that all ties together usually on her stuff. So I'm assuming the video imagery plays into that to some degree. I don't necessarily know how I feel about it so far. It's like an evolving process, you know? I'm still trying to gauge how I feel about it. I do know that I don't dislike it, which, for the record, I'm going to be honest with you guys. I'm not one of those reactors who just bops his head and says that he likes everything. If I don't like something, I will be honest with you guys. However, I will be fair, I will be open-minded, and I will be objective about it. But so far, I don't dislike it at all. We'll see if I end up liking it. Let's continue. Oh, she's got the Post Malone ink going on in this. All right. I like that. I will say I do like the beat. And, you know, I do want to point out that she does have a good voice. And I feel like a lot of people who criticize popular artists, they just all across the board dismiss those artists as if they have no talent. And that's not true at all. You know, I saw this like really brief clip of, for those who don't know, this is a kind of metal artist, Ronnie Radke, the band Falling in Reverse. And he was basically calling out people who were putting artists down for using like auto-tune and things like that, saying that auto-tune does not magically turn you into a great vocalist if you're not a good vocalist to begin with, and that almost everyone uses auto-tune to a certain degree because it adds texture over the voice. So, you know, these people who dismiss these pop artists out of hand for being bad singers because they use auto-tune, that's really not the case. You have to be a good singer to begin with. And I'm not saying that she even uses auto-tune. I don't even know. That was just a little side thing. But I do think that she has a really good voice, and she wouldn't have gotten this far and become this popular, obviously, if she didn't. But I will say that as a metalhead, I do like the sound of her voice. Let's keep going. All my mornings are Monday, stuck in an endless February. I took the miracle move on drug. The effects were temporary. And I love you. It's ruining my life. I love you. It's ruining my life. I like that, how the smoke has color in it. Okay, so remember what I said about symbolism here. There's some interesting imagery right there, because the smoke, I guess the flames really, they're meant to be flames. Those are the sole things that are in color in what is otherwise a black and white video, okay? And so she is longing for this guy. She obviously has just, you know, ended a relationship or maybe even an affair, possibly. But she's come away from it and she wants back in, you know? You know, she is still connecting and still kind of longing for this person. So she has the orange flame. She's still burning hot. And this other person has the blue flame. They're burning cold. So they're the ones who are distant. They're the ones who are aloof and just not feeling the same way. That's what I'm getting from that. And they're trying to communicate across a great distance, across a great divide, basically, even though they're right across from each other, typing on these typewriters. That's some clever symbolism, actually. I'll give credit where it's due. And I also like the fact that the music video itself is black and white, because for me, it helps to pay attention to certain symbols and certain details when a video is black and white, because when it's color, it sometimes feels too busy and there's too much going on. There's too much to pay attention to and you miss things. I don't dislike it at all. And her voice is pleasant to hear. Yeah, I it's not bad so far.
Oh,
I'm just noticing. Post Malone's got no face tattoos in this. That's weird. That's weird, man. Also, I hear she's mentioning your wife. So I'm assuming this probably was dealing with a relationship that was an affair. But of course, any and all of this, you guys can fill me in more in the comments if you know more. Is that Ethan Hawke? They got Ethan Hawke in this video? That's interesting. I don't usually see big name actors in like music videos, but then I don't really know much about mainstream music videos. I really haven't seen many. So that's the other thing. Like, you have to understand, guys, if I'm missing anything, if I'm like misinterpreting anything, or if I just seem like unusually ignorant about something, it's because I probably am, because I really don't know all that much about mainstream music. I'm very kind of just removed from it in terms of like what I listen to on a regular basis. And I don't really watch like music videos on TV or anything like that. I don't listen to the radio. So there's a lot of artists out there where when I tell people I've never heard of them, they're like looking at me like I'm bullshitting them. Like I'm, you know what I mean? Like, oh, come on. Like, really? Like, yeah, really? Like, I'm out of the loop with that kind of stuff. So I'm really coming from a blind perspective when it comes to this artist and just going based on like what I've heard about her, what I know. So fill in any blanks that you want to in the comments below, you know, explain things that I might be missing or getting wrong. Feel free to do so. I try and read all the comments that I get. Okay. I also think this is meant to be deliberately melodramatic. Like, I don't think that it's doing that just, like, incidentally. I think it's, like, tongue-in-cheek, right? Like, the slow pan out, the phone booth in the rain, and she's sitting on top of the phone booth, soaking wet. But, you know, I think that it's a well-put-together music video. And so far, here's what I'll say about the music. Objectively, I like it in the sense that I think it's good music, actually. I think that her voice is very good. Her voice is very, like, silky and very pleasant to the ears. And it's very smooth. And this has a very chill vibe, you know? It has the sort of chill vibe that I'm going to reference it again, that a lot of, like, retro, softer synthwave music has. And if you guys don't know what synthwave is, you guys should definitely check out that genre. It's basically like a revitalization of 80s music with like some other elements. So I appreciate that side of it. Now, is this something I would listen to really in my own time? Not really. It's not something I would really gravitate toward myself because it's just not exactly the vibe that I seek out when I go to music. Of course, I'm a metalhead, so you could probably understand that. But I do like smooth music. I do like soft music on occasion. And if someone played this for me, I wouldn't be mad at it. I'd be fine with it. You know, I'd much prefer if music like this was generally what was heard on the radio than a lot of other music. And I won't name names, but there are some big artists out there that I just think are not good. Objectively, I mean, not just that they're not to my taste. I do think that they're just not good. And I do think that there's something like very shallow and vapid about some of the artists out there today. I don't think that about Taylor Swift, and I don't think that I ever did, even when I didn't know much about her. I think that she's an extremely talented person who puts in a lot of hard work, and I think that it pays off just based on the fact that me, someone unfamiliar with her work, and someone just not exposed to those avenues of music, the fact that after hearing one song, I can come away with a very positive impression. So that says something. That speaks volumes. Pick up another floor, night lost in a mess. Yeah, that was Ethan Hawke. Last thing I saw that dude in was in Moon Knight. And, yeah, I just lost my train of thought. man, I really hope this doesn't get blocked, man. You know, this is like probably like definitely the biggest artist I've ever reacted to on my channel. Yeah, Colette39. Did you think I was gonna not react to this? Did you think I was gonna say no? I give everything a shot on this channel. I don't care. So I saw it was Taylor Swift featuring Post Malone. I was like, all right, that's unexpected, but we're doing it. We're doing it. Metalhead reacts. Let's go. Oh, man. Again, I didn't come into this with any preconceived ideas of what to expect because I just didn't know. So I wasn't going to like jump to any conclusions. What I will say is this. When I think of mainstream popular music artists, I tend to either think super electronic-y pop or hip-hop rap kind of stuff. And that's just because that is like the majority of what I hear in passing on a day-to-day basis. That seems to be like what the general audiences in the U.S. are into. That's the kind of music I hear out of passing cars. That's the kind of music I hear, you know, when I do hear snippets of radio music or whatever. When I hear soundtracks for films and stuff on TV, commercials and stuff. So that's just the kind of music that I've come to expect being the norm for people who consume mainstream music and are not into like, you know, alternative stuff. That being said, I also knew going into this, just from what I've heard, that she is far more than that. She's a much more well-rounded artist. She's done, I don't even know what she's done, but I think I've heard that she's even done some like folk style music, which is like, that came as a surprise to me. I think I read that a few weeks ago, because I get Taylor Swift stuff popping up in my Facebook feed. I also get like Xbox stuff and football stuff and other stuff that's not remotely relevant to me. But yeah, like she apparently did like some folk music. I do think that she started out as a country singer, if I'm not mistaken. And I also know that she's from PA, which is the state I live in right now. So yeah, it was a broad range that I kind of vaguely knew about when it came to like her styles and everything, what she's capable of, what she's dabbled in. But I didn't necessarily think that this would be like as stripped down as it was and as laid back and chill and like loungy and smooth as it was. This was far more chill and far more reserved than I might have expected. And again, I didn't expect anything in particular, but I didn't specifically expect this. So this was a vibe that I was not quite prepared for, but that I very quickly got into, because once again, this is not the general vibe that I go for with music, but I can be in a certain mood where I would listen to like this tone, where I would like this energy. It's very often been the case that I have listened to music in other genres, soft rock music, once again, synthwave, some vaporwave stuff, some electronic, indie, stuff that was like really chill, really just stripped down, relaxed, you know, had a very raw but soft approach. And there have definitely been times when I've been in the mood for that. And when I have, there's something about that music that has a really positive effect on my often chaotic and over-energetic mind. So this also had that effect on me. I like the energy that it gave off. I like her voice. I thought Post Malone did a good job as well. His voice was also like kind of reserved, and I would have maybe liked it a little bit if he was more prominent and more pronounced in the song. He was very much mostly paired with Taylor Swift's vocals, and they were mostly duetting. But it was good. You could clearly tell that there's talent here, and for any Taylor Swift fans, they're probably rolling their eyes right now. Like, yeah. Of course, you weirdo. Like, of course there's talent there. Like, this is Taylor Swift. But look, I'm just coming at it from my perspective. I'm coming at it as someone who didn't know what to look for, what to expect in something like this. And so I'm just pointing out where and how I recognize the talent, you know, and how it's on display for me personally and how I connected with that. So I'm pleasantly surprised, though, that this didn't go the route of being super, like obnoxiously electronic, if you know what I mean. Super in your face, super like poppy with like pop beats and just like kind of just loud, shallow vocals. This was actually very like intelligent and very well thought out. And, you know, it was like emotional. So I think that's good. Like that's something that we need more in mainstream music, because I think once again, and I could be speaking from partial ignorance, keep that in mind. Once again, I do think that there's a lot of shallow, not very meaningful, one-dimensional content in popular American music. And so I'm glad that she played it so modest and so composed in her song, because it completely shies away from the tropes and the stereotypes that you see in a lot of modern music. In an age of like very loud, very colorful, poppy, in-your-face stuff, for people who with, in my opinion, increasingly short attention spans, this was something that took its time, that felt very lived in, and that had a calmer, more complex energy to it, and was very much a more refined piece of music that you really have to let yourself absorb and process and pay attention to. And I like that. And that's the kind of music, even among music that I wouldn't necessarily gravitate toward, if any kind of music that's in the popular public sphere is going to win me over, it would be music that takes this kind of approach. So I don't know how surprised I am, if I'm surprised or not really, but I didn't mind the song at all. Again, it's not something that I would necessarily listen to in my own time, but if someone else was playing it, I wouldn't mind it. And I didn't dislike anything about this. And objectively speaking, two extremely, extremely talented artists. And it was a good collab. It was a good collab choice. Not something I would have predicted either. So Colette39, thank you for the Patreon request and for your support on Patreon. If anyone else wants to make a song request like Colette did, hop on Tier 4. Patreon is linked down below in the description. Or if you just want bonus content in general, early releases of videos, exclusive videos, then just hop on any tier. You can join the lowest tier and get in on those goodies. But we're not done yet. We're going to get into the lyrics and see what the song is dealing with. I was supposed to be sent away, but they forgot to come and get me. I was a functioning alcoholic till nobody noticed my new aesthetic. All of this is to say, I hope you're okay. But you're the reason, and no one here is to blame. But what about your quiet treason? And for a fortnight there, we were forever. Run into you sometimes. Ask about the weather. Now you're in my backyard, turned into good neighbors. Your wife waters flowers. I want to kill her. All my mornings are Mondays, stuck in an endless February. I took the miracle move-on drug. The effects were temporary. And I love you. It's ruining my life. I touched you for only a fortnight. For a fortnight there, we were together. Run into you sometimes. Comment on my sweater. Now you're at the mailbox. Turned into good neighbors. My husband is cheating. I want to kill him. Huh. Thought of calling you, but you won't pick up. Another fortnight lost in America. Move to Florida. Buy the car you want, but it won't start up until you touch me. So just, you know, FYI, I think that, you know, this is my personal view. I think that love songs are way overdone in popular music. And I'm glad that, like, metal and the genres I'm into don't really deal with that too much. But I also maintain that if you can find something unique or new or fresh to say about a love song or a relationship song, that I can respect, that I can commend. So this is obviously a breakup song, but it seems like it's about someone who's stuck in a reverie, someone who's just daydreaming and they're trapped by their own thoughts. Like the daydream is nicer and more appealing than the reality. So they just cling to those old feelings and live completely in the memories of what that relationship was, because it's better than having to turn and face the reality of the hurt and the pain and probably the loneliness that came afterward. And it also seems like maybe she had the feeling of touching upon something that felt like it was greater, like something that felt like it had a more significant purpose, like it was leading to something great. Like maybe the relationship was this beautiful thing that she needed in a dark moment in her life. And now that feeling belongs to someone else. And so, again, I'm thinking of those two flames in the video. And that might explain the lines like, your wife waters flowers, I want to kill her. And of course, even one of the main lines, for a fortnight there, we were forever. So it was this ideal dream and fantasy that seemed larger than life. And when it all came crashing back down to reality, the fantasy was all that was left to hold on to. But again, it's also, unless I'm misinterpreting that line, when it mentions wife, I think that pretty much confirms that this relationship had been an affair that this person was having with her. Unless this was before he was married, but I don't think so. I think it refers to a situation where these two were secretly together. So they had this forbidden, passionate thing, which, by the way, always crashes and burns. If you get into any kind of affair, and especially when the very thing that makes it work for you is the secrecy and taboo of the whole thing, you're basically just setting yourself up to be hurt, and to quite probably hurt other people as well. So I just think it's that big idea, that romanticized view of what it actually was, that came crumbling down for her. And now it's easier to keep living in that world instead of moving on. So that's pretty much where the song takes me when I read those lyrics. Again, it was interesting that Ethan Hawke was in that video. Is there like a deliberate connection there? Like, wasn't Ethan Hawke in, what's it called? Dead Poets Society? I've never seen that entire movie. And to be honest, it's not exactly my thing. It's not like my go-to film choice, but I've heard it's a good movie, and it obviously has phenomenal actors in it. Robin Williams, absolute legend. I'm pretty sure Ethan Hawke was in that. And so this song is from an album called the Tortured Poets Department. So that had to have been a deliberate casting choice, right? Let me know more in the comments, of course. That's if this video stays up, which I hope it does. Yeah, so that's pretty much my take on this. Man, this has turned out to be a long video. Who would have thought, man? Who would have thought? A day ago, I couldn't have pictured myself reacting to this, but here we are. And I didn't mind it. So, once again, thank you, Colette39, for your patronage and for the request. That's all for this one. Don't forget to make your song requests if you have them. Tier 4 on Patreon is your best option. And feel free to leave your background information, your input about this artist in the comments below. I try and read every comment that I get. And more content is on the way. Much love to the Nuclear family, and I will catch you all next time.